The council to Sunday Adeyemo, popularly known as Sunday Igbo, Chief Yomi Aliyu, a senior advocate of Nigeria, has alleged that his client is going through harrowing torture and pains, having been put in chains in a police cell in Cotonou, the capital of the Republic of Benin. The senior advocate, who spoke to journalists, also disclosed that Mr. Igboho would appear before a court in Benin by Wednesday morning for an extradition order. While reacting to news earlier making the rounds about his client's release, the counsel said the news was not true. He said instead that Igboho is being treated like an animal in the cell based on what he called an order from above. Political and public affairs analyst, and commentator Tumba Olabode Osini. He joins us live via Skype from the United Kingdom. Good to have you join us.
Thank you very much for having me.
So we saw how it played out with Nnamdi Kanu's case. He was brought in, and then the government announced that he has been brought in. No one even knew when all of that took place. But things seem to be slightly different with Sunday Igboho. There are a lot of intrigues surrounding his he's been brought back to the country by Interpol. Talk to us about what you think is playing out here, why it's taking long for the government to be able to bring him back.
Thank you very much. There are two major areas of argument here. There's this line of political and legal. Political would be a little bit related to government of the day in Nigeria asking for Chief Sunday Igboho to be extradited to Nigeria. But the question here is, how do we have to compare the case of Sunday Igboho to Nnamdi Kanu? Nnamdi Kanu jumped bail. That is the truth. This man is running for his life. Sunday Igboho is running for his life. We all witnessed July 1st when a large number of people invaded his private home, and in the process shooting and ended up killing two people and arrest so many people. That case is still before the court. Now let us go back quickly to Israel. Here we have someone, a Nigerian, who stood up to stand for people that have been killed, maimed in part of, as it is now, part of Nigeria. And the complaint that the Fulani herdsmen that have been doing this, that have been perpetrating these atrocities, none of them is yet to be shown. None of them is yet to be arrested. That is the truth. I want to be challenged. No single Fulani herdsmen have been arrested openly and shown to the whole world that this man was arrested for committing this kind of atrocities. And it goes on and on. But the truth of the matter is, Sunday Igboho is not a criminal. Sunday Igboho...
And Mr. Osini, that's where the challenge is here. Because a lot of people are now citing that extradition treaty of 1984 between Nigeria, Ghana, Togo, Benin Republic. And they're saying that even his lawyer is also citing that, saying that for political fugitives, that treaty does not support the extradition of political fugitives. But the government is not charging him based on that. You have said he's not a criminal. But that's what the federal government is alleging. They are saying they found he was allegedly stockpiling weapons. And that's where the challenge is. On one hand, people say he's a political fugitive, but that's not why the government is looking for him, according to the DSS.
Well, you and I know, even though I don't live in Nigeria, but I can tell you for free that I see Nigeria and Nigerians more clearer from where I live. The truth of the matter is DSS have messed up so many cases. Now, the issue of getting Sunday Igboho back to Nigeria has to be decided by the court. The court will have to take a decision on that. There must be enough evidence to show that Sunday Igboho is a criminal. He has done a lot of, things that warrant things that they have to get him back to. Back to Nigeria. Let us wait. The court in Benin is a jurisdiction of the Republic of Benin. Yes, there is a common body like the ECOWAS But still does not mean Nigeria can just wake up in the morning and dictate to the Republic of Benin what to do. So the court in the Republic of Benin, we have to go through the evidence of the case of Sunday Igbo, his lawyers. And I have no doubt in my mind that put everything together, any lawyer can win that case, because Sunday Igbo is not a criminal. Sunday Igbo was running for his life. He has done a noble thing. So put that together, I'm sure the court in Benin will tell the state that they cannot return Sunday Igbo to Nigeria.
So let me just, because this is a question a lot of people seem to be asking, I just want to pose it to you just in case you have an idea, because everyone is wondering. So Nnamdi Kanu has been brought back. Sunday Igbo is likely to be brought back. And the question people are asking is, so what next? What next, you know, for the federal government?
Well, again, I'm sorry, I'm not being, I don't want to be trivial here. What next for the federal government? What has the federal government been doing the last number of years that we've been there? They have been using a constitution that's fraudulent, that is flooded with, flooded with so many discrepancies, and we are not moving anywhere. Nigeria is a great country, supposed to be a great country. But because of the bad governance from A to Z of where we are today, we've not been able to achieve anything. And if part of a country now turns around and say, you know what, let us revert back to regionalism, let us do our business we find it fit, and everybody can do that at their own space, why is federal government, why do they have to stick to a faulty, a seriously bad put together constitution? I'm sorry, might not be exactly what many people want to hear, but the truth of the matter is, here is this, some people are now come together and say, you know what, enough is enough. We cannot continue this kind of a relationship, this kind of association cannot continue. It's not bringing our people any joy. We have our people doing most fantastically outside the country. They are doing very well, but here we have a country where that belongs to them. They have nothing to show for all what they have. So really and honestly, federal government can continue to try. And again, I want to repeat, the case of Igboho is not the same with the case of Nnamdi Kanu. Igboho did not jump bail. Igboho chose to run for his life and trying to do the best for his family. Igboho is not a criminal. So, and I would be surprised if any way federal government of Nigeria can win the case in front of a Republic of Benin court of law.
All right, thank you so much for talking to us. We understand that the case will be in court today in Benin. We'll see how that plays out. Political analyst and public affairs commentator Olabode Oseni, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very much for having me, TVC.